Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did the characteristics of solid, liquid and gaseous state, and now based on that we have learned a term, that is intermolecular interaction. So what is that? Let us see about it. So basically, intermolecular interaction involves intermolecular force of attraction between the neighboring molecules. As we know that when we are talking about a solid, liquid or gas or any kind of matter, there is intermolecular force of attraction between the molecules. And because of that, they have a particular shape, they have a particular volume, or they have a particular characteristic depending on this intermolecular force of attraction. So now moving towards the further thing. And then this is situated at a distance much closer in comparison with their molecular diameter, and that is about 10 raised to minus 10 meter. So they have a limited range also, that is between or less than 10 raised to minus 10 meter, they have intermolecular force of attraction between the molecules of when we are talking about the matter. Now moving towards the next one, that is what is basically the role of intermolecular interaction or the intermolecular force of attraction. So the first thing is, this force keeps the molecule of the matter together, and that is true. That is, for solid, the intermolecular force of attraction is more. That's the reason the two molecules, or more than two molecules of the solids, are very close to each other and they are very intact, and hence we could say that they have particular shape and particular volume. But for liquid, the intermolecular force is very much less, and hence they have a fluidity characteristic. And talking about the gas, they have negligible intermolecular force of attraction, and hence they have basically they are apart from each other, the molecules have been apart from each other, and has no shape and volume. So now talking about the next one, that is at high temperature and low pressure, the kinetic energy of molecules is high and the intermolecular force of attraction are low. So this helps the gaseous substance to retain its gaseous state. Now talking about the temperature of a gas, suppose if I have increased the temperature, and as I have said that if I increase the temperature, then the kinetic energy of that gas will be more, and hence they will rapidly, or they will randomly, in which they were already also, they are randomly moving from each other. So now they will collide with each other, and hence the volume will be increased. So what will happen is, the intermolecular space between the two molecules was earlier more, but now because of temperature has been increased and the pressure has been decreased, so this will led to the increase in volume, and hence the intermolecular distance between the two molecules will be increased, and hence we can see a random motion. And earlier also it was present in gas, but because the distance are been far away, again this will be present in gas itself. So that's why the last statement says that this helps the gaseous state to retain as gaseous state. So the gaseous state compound will be stay as the gaseous state itself only if we increase the temperature and decrease the pressure. Now talking about the next one, that is at low temperature and high pressure, the kinetic energy is low and the intermolecular force of attraction will be strong. Thus the gaseous molecules aggregate and liquefy, forming liquid drops. So let me give you an example. Suppose for H2O gas, suppose if H2O is present in a gaseous state, so if we decrease the temperature, so what happens is the gaseous molecules, they will interact with each other and they will come close to each other because the temperature has been decreased. So if the temperature has been decreased, then the volume will be reduced. And the volume gets reduced, this volume is reduced because the molecules, they have came close to each other, and hence the intermolecular distance, they have now been decreased and they are very close to each other. So this will create what? This will create actually intermolecular force of attraction, because the two molecules are very close to each other now. So this will generate the intermolecular force of attraction, and if the intermolecular force of attraction will increase, that the volume will decrease, and yes, they will aggregate with each other, they will come close to each other. So if the gas comes close to each other, they start to liquefy, and hence the liquid drops are being formed. So this is what they have been mentioned here, and that's what I was talking about. So moving towards the next one, that is the last one, that is if the temperature is further lowered, then kinetic energy decreases, making the intermolecular force of attraction more stronger, and molecule becomes motionless and liquid freezes to solid. Again, suppose I'll start from that's third point to fourth point, and this will make your concept very clear. Suppose if H2O, that is the vapors, are present in a gaseous state. If I decrease the temperature, and suppose if I increase the pressure, so what will happen is the volume will decrease, and the intermolecular distance, it will also decrease with intermolecular force of attraction, that will increase. The force of attraction will increase and they will come close to each other. So the gas will now be converted into basically liquid. So suppose if liquid, suppose if the phase has been changed from gases to liquid. So again, if I decrease the temperature, so what will happen is the intermolecular force of attraction will increase with the intermolecular distance, that will go on decreasing.
So the intermolecular force, if it increases, but this intermolecular force, if it is more, this is a property of solid. So basically what we are going to do is we are converting the gas into first liquid, and then we are converting the liquid into a solid. So this is nothing more as the freezing of the liquid. So this is what the interaction, and you should understand the interaction between the molecules. So let me give you an example of ice. I hope you have understood that this concept is very much clear to you. So suppose when I'm talking about ice, so suppose ice is something which is made up of water. Yes, we know it. But ice is present in a solid state. Suppose if I increase the temperature, so what will happen is the ice which is present in solid state, it will convert into a liquid state. Again, that will be water itself. But okay. So now suppose this happens if I increase the temperature, or if I will say that if I increase the energy, or if I increase the volume.
So suppose if that I have converted a solid into liquid. So now suppose if I increase the temperature, that is by increasing the energy, so what will happen is the intermolecular force will decrease, and yes, it will convert into a gaseous, that is nothing but the water vapor. But the component will be the same, that is I'm talking about H2. But when we are talking, when the temperature is being decreased, so what will happen? So suppose if the temperature is lowered by increasing pressure, so this gas will be converted into liquid. And again, if I decrease the temperature more, if I decrease the temperature actually, then what will happen? This liquid will be converted into solid ice. So now in this case the delta H will be the negative. This delta H is nothing but the enthalpy that will go on decreasing if I convert the gas to liquid and liquid to solid. So this is what I was talking about. So in this case the intermolecular force of attraction plays a very vital role. As you can see, the component is the same, but the thing is that kind of matter can change its phase. It depends on temperature and pressure. So if temperature has been increased or decreased, they have this kind of effect, as you can see. So these are the phase transformation of a particular matter, that is in this case I have talked about ice, or that is water. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video, and yes, you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.